I am using my new Lion Brand. Lion Brand had a sale for a dollar for landscape yarn, so of course I bought quite a few of them, so I'm playing. One of my favorite hats to do is using the bead stitch and then a half double crochet in between the bead stitch. And a lot of people say, you know, what do you use for a pattern? And I don't use a pattern. I just make my hats very simply. So I figured I'd do a video and kind of tell you how I do it. I use a K-hook and I start a foundation half double crochet to fit my head. So this, I use 50 with a K-hook, which, and I crochet very loosely. So that gives my hats a lot of stretch around the edge, which I like. So 50 works for me, but everybody crochets different. So I usually just, when I first started doing these myself, I would just try them around my head. Now I just kind of know. But after I got that half double crochet done, I did half double crochet in the third loop for one, and then a half double crochet a single crochet in the third loop. But at that point, this is when I make my hat's foot fill out a little bit because I don't like them close to my head. So every fifth stitch, I do two single crochets in the back in the third loop, and that opens up my hat all the way around. So I do one, two single crochet in the third loop together, and then I just do one single crochet in each third loop for four, and then in the fifth one I do two again in each in that stitch and work my way around my hat, and that makes it really full. And when you work in your hat that way, you'll find, oh my god, this looks really weird, but it all works out. Then I do my bead stitch on the next row, and if you look up bead stitch, and I usually post the link for that as well, but you wrap it around your single crochet post. So it shows on the regular bead stitch, you do it four or five times. I only wrap three times. I do three half double crochets around my bead stitch. And with a K-hook, that seems to be plenty enough. The bead stitch gives the hat a really nice texture, especially if you're using a hat that needs some texture to it to hold it up. So with this yarn, it works really well. So I do a bead stitch row, half double crochet, bead stitch, half double crochet, all the way. Now, when you decrease a hat working this way, you're basically going backwards. So when you start a hat from the magic ring or whatever method you use, you do two, say you're doing half double crochets, you do eight half double crochets or 10 half double crochets in your ring, and then you do two in every stitch after that, and then you do two and then one. So you're basically going backwards with that concept. So when I get to this point, I start doing six half double crochets and then decrease one half double crochet. Six half double crochets, decrease. The next row, I'm decreasing every five, every four, every three, every two, and then when I get to the very end, I've got two half double crochets together in every stitch, and I just do a drawstring close, pull it all together, and sew it in. So you get the same effect, but because I add this fullness to the first row, my hats don't get that boxy look, which I hate when I start my hats from the top. So I've tried many patterns, and I'm just never happy with it. The other thing I wanted to tell you was working with yarn that changes color, it's horrible because when you have to change rows, like if you're doing all half double crochet, you can make it work and the rows turn into each other. But when you're changing colors, you have to stop that row and then start a new row with your new stitch. So what I found with this stitch, and you won't even really see, this is my seam. So the colors really come close to each other. It's not perfect, but it's better than joining every row and starting a new color because I don't like that jump. So what I do is if I'm doing my bead stitch, I join into my bead stitch. I don't chain one. I just go directly up into the top of my bead stitch and I do my half double crochet. So I'm just continuing the next row right after that. But I do join my bead stitches because it does bring them together better. So I join right in here into my bead stitch and then half double crochet right up into the center. Let me show you on one that you can really see. Right up into the center of my bead stitch on the first bead stitch. And then I just work my bead stitch around. When I get to the end, I join my bead stitch. But on the half double crochet rows, when I get to the end of my half double crochet row, I immediately begin my bead stitch into the next one. That keeps my colors actually pretty good. My join, doesn't show up so bad, because it's a pet peeve of mine. When I see that jump, I really get frustrated. The only part that I have an issue with, and where was it? It's hiding on me. Let me turn my head a little bit. My band tucked under here. On my very first row, when I'm doing my half double crochet in the third loop, that's the only problem. The only place that I have a problem is on that one piece, and I'm working on that. But I like to join them on the half double crochet in the third loop row, so I always get that color change, and I hate it. So I don't. There's not really a lot you can do when you're working with yarn like that, unless somebody else has a grand way of fixing that. But anyway, that's it in a nutshell. It's very, very simple. I use my eye. I don't measure. When I see my hat getting tall enough, that's when I start decreasing. So I've done so many that I really don't need to measure. You can use charts, and that's how I learned, by using charts to see how tall you should make a hat, how big you should make your hat. But after you do so many of them without a pattern, you just kind of know by looking at it that it's right. So anyway, that's my bead stitch hat with my dollar yarn from Lion Brand, and it's actually pretty. I couldn't have planned the colors out better. I didn't plan this at all. It just kind of worked up that way. I would have never chosen colors to go together like this, but it's really a pretty yarn. So anyway, how beautiful is that? Such a pretty hat. That yarn's so beautiful to work with. I hope you enjoyed.